Yes, that's Lawrence. He's retarded. And Thomas.
Dennis.
And Paul. And today we're going to do a 1v1 positioning of the defender near your own D. And Lawrence, that means that the attackers and the defense are a no goal.
Best opening ever!
This one's going to give us some points.
Yeah. A lot of comments.
Charlotte.
Charlotte, Leia, and Maurits are not here because last time they got a bit scared by Gary. Maybe you've noticed one of the last videos. Gary's watching you.
Gary's
and they were so scared of Gary,
Gary is watching.
That they didn't want to show up.
Now
they're just too scared.
I hate you.
Now we know who Gary is.
But we know who Gary is now. And he's not that scared.
No, he's a very nice
guy.
He put on the heaters for us.
Large teeth. Yeah. Big beard.
Paul, yeah. What are we doing?
Okay, so we're doing defensive positioning. Positioning of the defender in a 1v1 duel near your own D. So Thomas, I need you inside the D. And Lawrence, I need you over there with the balls. And what we see
is Thomas.
It's Thomas. And also we see gate number one. We see gate number two. And gate number three. Lawrence will be with the balls.
I'm not there.
No, you're not there. Put down the camera.
Wait, Lawrence. I have to position the camera somewhere.
Okay, so Lawrence is there with the balls. Thomas is behind gate number one, two, and three. Lawrence can go towards goal only after he takes the ball and carries it through one of the gates. After which Poggio will be defending inside the D. And Pog needs to position himself right. Let's show. So basically, what we've seen so far is the moment an attacker does like a forehand turn or goes over my backhand, it's really hard to get the ball. And Pog did it twice, I did it once. If you even try to get the ball like this with a swing, you'll get a penalty corner against. So that's something you want to try to avoid. Well, my backhand block is also not very strong, so what I need to do is when Poggio is my attacker and I'm defending him, I need to position myself right shoulder in front of right shoulder.
Wait.
I need to position myself right shoulder in front of right shoulder. Also my left foot a little bit in front, meaning that now the space for Thomas is over there. If he tries to go this way, I will block him out with my left glove. He will go there again. And now I can channel him over my forehand to the easy side for the goalie, because the more we go to the side, the more easy it is for Dennis to defend that as well.
Yeah.
This is an old outdoor technique, where we used to always defend right shoulder, but indoors, backhand is dangerous. So we need to try to give the open space over our forehand. And try,
yeah.
And if you try to go over my backhand, I will not put my backhand down, but I will try to close it again with my forehand, leaving the space here and channeling him back. Ah! And then you get the ball.
Okay.
Easy as that.
Pointers,
make sure that the right shoulder of the defender is in front of the right shoulder of the attacker. And if he tries to move over my backhand, then I move as well and close it down with my forehand and never with the backhand, because that's the weak side, especially indoors when everything needs to stay on the ground. It makes it easier for Dennis as well. And that's our basic pointers of defending. More focus on channeling to the forehand than you would do outdoors, because you have less options than outdoors. Hey, if you like it, then
give
we did a good job.
Up.
Then we did a very good job.
Yeah. And if you have any questions as well,
or you can ask them.
Put it in the comments.
Ah, nice.
Yeah.
Or if you're watching this in Premiere, now you do it in the super chat.
In the super chat.
Yes, put it in the super chat.
Hit the like button.
Hit the like.
Yeah. And follow us on
Instagram.
All the other chat.
Oh, yeah.
Instagram.
Yeah. Facebook.
Twitter.
YouTube.
Twitter, YouTube.
Snapchat.
And
Grindr, bye bye.
Thank you for watching.